So what I have here now is the operational induction heater unit, which I'm going to use to levitate metal. But I just first want to go through just a few of the pieces to it and some particular modifications so you can do this yourself. Probably the most important thing to consider are your MOSFETs, since these are going to be handling all that current. What I have here is a chassis mount package. It is mounted on an aluminum heatsink that I'm using doing water cooling. The gate goes through a shielded cable to a 10 ohm non-inductive resistor. I am not using any ferrite beads with this MOSFET. It's not necessary. The clamping diodes are connected right to the gate and the source here. The capacitor is a conduction cooled capacitor, and I'm using an aluminum block with water cooling, which is absolutely essential. Here is the impedance matching transformer with a lit type wire around it to handle the current, which at the frequencies we're doing travel via the skin effect. I also have a fan to blow cool air to cool us off, since this gets very hot. Looking dead on, here is the coil that I'm going to use for levitating metal. I've built this design so that I can easily swap out different coils here just by unclamping and putting a different coil in. This one is designed with a multiple turns going out in a cone, with the uppermost turn in the opposite direction to contain the floating object. So I'm going to suspend a little piece of aluminum. I'm going to use a quartz rod to feed it through. So I'm actually suspending this with about 5 amps of current coming off the mains at 240 volts, so about 1 kilowatt of power. This is a piece of steel. Now we're going to levitate a piece of copper.